Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's GTA 5 video, I'm going to be telling you guys about 10 things you need to know before you end up buying the Nagasaki Outlaw in GTA Online. So first things first, sorry if I sound a little bit different. It seems as if I've caught a little bit of a cold, but don't worry, I'm going to be powering through it, getting you through this video and more over the next couple of days. But anyways, let's keep our focus on the Nagasaki Outlaw. This is an interesting vehicle, and I don't want to start anything off with a negative note, but I think this might be the worst of the vehicles that we've looked at so far, at least the unreleased ones from the Diamond Casino heist. So if you're interested in purchasing the Nagasaki Outlaw, it's going to be available on the Southern San Andreas Super Auto site for a base price of $1,268,000 and a trade price or a discounted price of $951,000. So that means by unlocking the trade price, you would save $317,000 on this vehicle, which is a pretty good chunk of change, so it honestly might be worth it if you're interested in getting this car. Now, you might also be wondering, well, how do you go about getting the trade price for this vehicle? Well, you actually have to unlock it by using it as an escape vehicle for the Diamond Casino heist. So essentially, all you have to do is when you're on your planning board and you're choosing escape vehicles, just toggle back and forth and get to the Nagasaki Outlaw. And I don't know about you guys, but in my opinion, every time I've had to go get the Outlaw as the vehicle for the escape, it's always been like surrounded by Meriwether. It's been like one of the hardest missions ever. So I don't know if Rockstar did that intentionally, but that is how you can save $317,000 on this currently unreleased car in online. But anyways, let's take this vehicle into the Los Santos custom shop today. And I'm not going to lie to you guys, when I brought this in here, I was so disappointed. I thought there was going to be some amazing customization on here. Not so much. As you guys can see, only 11 customization options. Like, wah, wah. That is horrible. In fact, there isn't a single unique option that you can actually put on this vehicle. All of them are just standard upgrades like armor, engine, brakes, etc. However, I wanted to stay optimistic and I was thinking, you know, maybe the liveries will have something cool. But nope, not even the liveries. Those are just like the normal gun running ones that we unlocked a couple of years ago, like the Naval Battle and Modern 5 Color, stuff like that. So nothing that's really all that exciting. Really disappointing right there. So I guess we now have to move on to resprays where you have a primary and a secondary color. Your primary color is basically going to affect the entire body of the vehicle. Anything that isn't that black plastic, and anything that isn't a roll cage. And your secondary color is going to have an impact on pretty much everything that is a roll cage. And this also has an impact on some things underneath the vehicle, so pay attention to that as well. So that's what your primary and your secondary color does. Now after that, the only other thing I found interesting with this vehicle was the stock rims. So it looks like they're using off-road tires, but that off-road tire rim doesn't exist. Now, another thing that I noticed is that even though you can replicate the design of the off-road tires on this vehicle, the stock tires that Rockstar put are thicker, and in my opinion, look a little bit better. So we'll talk about why that's okay in a little bit, but that's just something interesting that I picked up there while in the LSC. Now that we've got the vehicle outside, the first thing I wanted to take a look at is, could we change the color of the stock rims? The answer is yes. So that's good news for being able to keep those stock tires, and you can change them to whatever you want. They honestly look like sports car wheels on this vehicle because there's no off-road wheel that looks like that. So that's good news right there. And then I wanted to see if we could open up all the doors. Surprisingly, only the passenger and driver's side open, but they do open pretty cool. They don't open like standard doors per se. They kind of open up at an angle, and that is actually really cool. There's also like this little gap in the door sill where like you can literally see through the car. I found that to be kind of interesting. And the headlights on this vehicle are pretty unique as well. I thought Rockstar was going to take advantage of all the little lights that they actually have on here, but unfortunately the brights just get brighter and that's about it. Now, if you guys are wondering what this vehicle is based off of in real life, I think it's most closely resembled to a Can-Am Maverick, but it could also be a Polaris Off-Road or an RZR or even a General. You guys have probably seen vehicles like this in real life. They're not ATVs and they're not like, you know, road vehicles, but they're kind of like a hybrid for going off-roading. And that's kind of what we're getting here. Now, one other thing to note about the Outlaw in the Los Santos Custom Shop, it was supposed to have suspension upgrades according to the in-game files. However, it looks like those were cut out at the last minute. We'll talk about some of the other things Rockstar might have done to this vehicle in a little bit, but it looks like at least at a minimum, this car was supposed to have some suspension upgrades. Now, getting onto the vehicle itself, this thing is really fun. Now, it's not all that fast as far as when you're driving it on the streets of Los Santos. In fact, I think its top speed is around 117 miles per hour, which, to give you guys some intel on how fast that really is, the ASBO that was added in this update, its top speed is 126. So it's 9 miles per hour slower than the ASBO, but this thing is an off-roading beast. It is so much fun to take off-roading, and I think it's actually a really good off-road car. Now, one of the things that I was like super focused on is the back suspension. It's like so bouncy. It goes like up and down and side to side. It's really cool, and I don't know if that helps with like the balance of this vehicle, but we tried to do like a couple of fun experiments, like taking this up Mount Chiliad, and this little guy had no problem doing some like insane off-roading. Another thing I've noticed about this vehicle is it like doesn't seem to take damage either. Now, when I spawn these cars in the game, I make them invincible and I make them auto repair so that you guys can see them in their like perfect form. But for this, like I actually went about and turned off the invincibility and I wanted to see if this car could like actually take any damage. And the answer is hardly. Even tumbling down Mount Chiliad, this thing survived so nicely. So that means that whatever you guys decide to do in game, it's probably going to survive that as well. In fact, the only real thing I noticed about this vehicle is that the doors would sometimes come off and that you would like crush the reverse and brake lights on the back. But outside of that, I'm guessing that's why Rockstar has like the roll cage on the top, because literally nothing else on this vehicle was impacted here. Like, it was totally flawless. So I would say from like a durability standpoint, this honestly is one of the best vehicles in the game. And it also like turns really quickly. Like, this is a weird car. I want to dislike it, but it's so much fun. And that's why I think, surprisingly, even though it has its flaws, a lot of people are going to end up buying this vehicle. So what's my opinion on this little off-road car? I'm kind of torn by it. I think Rockstar like literally decided to add this vehicle at the last minute, because like why else would it literally have zero customization options here? I mean, there's so much that you can do to this car. You could change the exhaust, you could change the front bumpers, you could change the fire extinguishers that are on the back to make them something different, or change the colors of them or remove them altogether. You could put stuff on the roof, you could, you know, add antennas or vortex generators, or whatever the case is. But Rockstar, again, for whatever reason, just said, nah, we're not gonna do that. So the fact that it has like literally zero customization, that's a little bit strange. In fact, I don't think there's been a vehicle added into Grand Theft Auto Online with no customization options like since 2013, like the original vehicles that Rockstar had in the game. Like, even the worst customizable cars have like one or two options that you could change. I'm looking at you, JB700W, that Rockstar just introduced. I mean, you could even change the guns and the weapons on that, which is at least a slight upgrade. This just, again, has absolutely nothing. But if you guys are looking purely for just a fun off-road vehicle, this might not be a bad buy. I definitely wouldn't like use it to go from point A to point B. Also, because it has no windows and very little protection, you could get shot super easily in this car. So it's not going to offer much in terms of the day-to-day dangers of driving around in Los Santos. But I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. What do you think of the Nagasaki Outlaw 4x4 off-road vehicle? Are you going to be buying this car? Are you going to be staying away from it? Will you wait till it goes on discount sale or you get the trade price for the vehicle? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you want to stay up to date on all the latest GTA and all the Diamond Casino Heist videos that I'm doing here on my channel over the next couple of days and weeks. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.